In this video, we'll apply our knowledge of indirect taxes to correct market failure. Specifically, we'll see how indirect taxes can be used to correct a negative production externality. Assume a firm is producing widgets and the byproduct of widgets is chemical waste. If that waste is disposed of in a way that harms the environment, there is a possible negative externality there. It could be in the harm done to the environment and the suffering of the people who live nearby such hazardous production sites. Let's look at the problem diagrammatically and then apply indirect taxes as a solution. You've learned this diagram earlier in the start of A2. If you need a refresher, I'll include the link in the video description. This diagram illustrates a negative production externality. The free market equilibrium occurs where marginal private benefit intersects marginal private cost. Since there is a negative production externality, marginal private benefit and marginal social benefit are the same. At this point, there's a marginal external cost of AB per unit. Therefore, the marginal social cost is above the marginal private cost curve. This product is overproduced and results in negative production externalities such as air pollution and other environmental damage. Therefore, the socially optimal level of production would be at Q0 at price P0. Due to the overproduction, there's a deadweight loss or welfare loss of triangle ABC. If the government intervenes in this market and wants to reduce the quantity produced, it could impose an indirect tax of AB per unit of production. That would internalize the externality, which means the cost of the externality has been pushed back onto the economic agent producing it. Currently, the cost is external and thus is an externality. After the specific indirect tax, it would be internalized. Here's how that would look. The end result would be that the marginal private cost plus the tax would equal the marginal social cost. In the next slide, we'll see the market equilibrium for a good before and after a tax is applied. The initial equilibrium for this good is P star Q star. Once the government imposes a specific tax, it would shift the producer's supply curve leftward by the amount of the tax due to the increased cost of production, which would result in a higher market price of P1 and a lower market quantity of Q1. To evaluate indirect taxes as a solution to reducing negative externalities, we have to answer two questions. First, how has the value of the externality been determined? In the case of something like air pollution, how do you place an accurate value on the damage that has been done? Some effects will not appear immediately in the short run. Serious diseases may impact people's health in the long run. How do you measure that? Second, how much tax is enough? A government can under or overtax an industry, which results in either too little being done to address an externality or too much. If an excessive burden is put on businesses, this can lead to unemployment and unnecessarily high business costs. By now, you should have an understanding of how indirect taxes can be used to correct negative production externalities. If you need more help, leave a comment below or email me at enhancedtuition@gmail.com.